calls himself the Dirt Doctor, turning his mother's Northwest Side property into a dump. As part of a 12 News investigation, I've spent the last several months wading through complaints and neighbors' comments, poring over city records and court documents, all trying to answer one simple question: why can't he be stopped?
And the name of the game in the excavating business is location, location.
Mark Flessis is the Dirt Doctor.
In a perfect world, we'd like to see this all filled in.
It may be his perfect dream, but it's become a nightmare for the city of Milwaukee.
Mr. Flessis is quite an eccentric character.
That's how Alderman Jim Bull describes Flessis, the constituent who has filled his inbox with messages full of ideas for developing the land behind his mother's home on North 107th Street.
It is the equivalent of spaghetti at the wall.
But in this case, the wall is prime real estate, 4.5 acres or so, zoned residential, bordered by apartment buildings, schools, and private homes. Land that Assistant City Attorney Jay Unora argues is being used illegally as a dump.
By the calculations of the city, it appears that there was over 700 full dump trucks of dirt put on these properties without any sort of permit.
The only permit Flessis has was granted in 2008. It allowed him to build a dirt berm around the land as long as it was no higher than 6 feet above adjacent properties.
270 of them rode in here, dumped their loads and shot out of here. In other words, it was an unbelievable sight.
Flessis didn't flinch when we asked to see his property. He spoke freely about his business.
I got over 1,000 loads from the Holiday Inn Express.
Flessis got similar loads of clay from the excavation of the new Hilton Garden Inn and truckloads of debris from the Highway 45 construction project between Appleton and Good Hope. With every load, the berm grew until Flessis was no longer in compliance with the 6-foot limit.
So if you compare the property over there
to this,
up to 6 feet here, this is clearly higher than...
Oh, of course.
According to contractors who spoke to 12 News, the Dirt Doctor collected some $40 a load. Flessis says building up the land will help him build this.
This is the whole thing. If you've got a name...
The Chapel Manor Assisted Care Facility.
We're showing you that we have legitimate plans coming going forward. We've had engineering plans which we submitted to the city.
The big problem with the plans, according to city ordinance, the land isn't zoned for the project. That hasn't stopped Flessis. Neither have the nuisance complaints about the truck traffic and runoff filed with Alderman Bull's office.
When you deal with an alderman, we make a phone call to the proper person at DNS and we say, do what you need to do to deal with this problem.
Why are we almost at the 5-year mark and the city and yourself and your mother haven't been able to get this rectified yet?
I think there's been a, I take blame. I take responsibility.
Since 2008, the Department of Neighborhood Services has issued numerous stop orders and levied fines ranging from $334 to $384. But Flessis says the amounts are so small, they don't motivate him to stop, something Alderman Bull has seen before.
We've seen that on many properties here in the city of Milwaukee, where there are individuals at times who will incur a great amount of expense in fines, orders, reinspection fees that go on and on and on. It's a vicious cycle sometimes that unfortunately we don't have the tools at hand legally to properly rectify.
As long as Flessis pays the fees, fines, and property taxes on behalf of his mother, who owns the property, he can delay some, but not all, actions against them.
There's going to be no more of this activity until we hash out the merits of this.
The Flessis case is now in front of Circuit Court Judge Christopher Foley.
I'll put it in plain English for you, Mr. Unora. I'll kick their butts if they don't comply with this.
Judge Foley ordered the Dirt Doctor to stop infilling and file for a new permit for erosion control measures. It's another court order with fines and fees attached. Fines and fees that Alderman Bull says won't stop chronic offenders.
For the chronic cases, I think that the state should consider providing authority to issue higher fines. If the nickel and diming fines aren't working, we've got to take it a step to another level.
Now, we contacted Neighborhood Services about this case, but the commissioner says due to ongoing litigation, they don't want to talk about anything right now.
Craig, a lot of legwork in this case. Now, if the city were to seize the property as a nuisance, it would cost taxpayers.
Absolutely, Kathy. The big thing there is the if that could happen. The taxpayer, of course, you at home, would end up paying to remove all of that dirt, which could cost millions of dollars. Now, coming up in our next half hour, our 12 News investigation is going to take a look at really what the city is up against in this case and other cases like this, and ultimately what can be done about it.
Some more questions. All right. Thanks, Craig. Well